first time the public noticed mods and rockers coming to blows was Easter Bank Holiday in 1964 at Clacton. Events took the media by surprise, and the cameras didn't get there until the day after.
Chief Constable, how serious was this disturbance at the weekend? Was it in fact a gang fight?
Not as far as we know. It was several hundred young people, rather at a loose end over the weekend.
And what happened, as far as the police are concerned?
They came into the town, and finding not much else to do, they committed several acts of wanton and purposeless damage, so that the police had to turn out in some strength to deal with them.
Were you and your friends mods or rockers?
Mods. Well, we're mods when we're dressed up, you know.
You are
mods.
What caused all this trouble yesterday?
Boredom.
On whose part?
Well, on both.
What happened?
The doodan.
Well, there was lots of things, you know. They started, you know what rockers are like, don't you?
Well, I don't. No, you tell me.
Well, they... You know, their motorbikes, they started bashing into the scooters and knocking our motors.
Uh-huh. And what else happened?
So we, it was their fault as well as ours.
Where do you reckon the next battle of that kind is going to be?
Well, it's hard to say, isn't it? Whitson it'll be, won't it?
It'll be Whitson, won't it?
Be down Brighton, more or less.
At Whitson and in August, the TV cameras and the police were ready. The battles were smaller than at Clacton, but got much wider coverage.
People try to put us to imagination just because
Dan Cohen, a young postgraduate student from Johannesburg, was there too. He was researching social reaction to juvenile delinquency and saw that the mods and rockers story made a fascinating case study.
I was always playing three roles. I would sometimes walk around during the day dressed in jeans and trying to listen and overhear conversations and talk to kids at youth clubs and talk to kids in the street. And then I would change out of my gear and put on a suit and tie and go and interview a magistrate and hear a completely different version. And then I'd go home and, or I'd go to the sleep, stay up in a club all night and come up the next morning and buy the Mirror or the Express and see another reality. But to see those three different realities, the world that it looked like for the kids, the world that it looked like for a middle-class magistrate sitting miles away who's never been to the beach, and the world that it was like for a Daily Express reporter were different worlds. Not different worlds in the literal sense, but different worlds in the sense of different images of the same world. And that's what sociology is. You have to find some ways of reconciling, of finding the relationships between them.
Cohen realized that media coverage was a crucial link between the different worlds he encountered. He saw for himself that the press exaggerated the scale of the disturbances and the amount of damage and violence. He wasn't the only one to come to that conclusion.
Well, I think this is partly a case where the press has let us down nationally. I think this has been vastly exaggerated. At the most, £200 of damage was done at Clacton.
One of the newspapers itself said that had there been an international incident that justified the headlines in the papers during the weekend, this wouldn't have even been reported.
The press coverage triggered a reaction out of all proportion to the original incidents.
Collect them all up and put them on a boat and send them out to Cyprus where our boys are and bring our boys back that's got common sense.
Blimey, I think the police should have been a bit harder on them.
Bring back that cat!
In 1972, Cohen published Folk Devils and Moral Panics, and provided the classic formulation of how a moral panic works.
The media, by their reaction, kept the panic going and therefore, in a sense, amplified it. And the police, by going along with it, added to the drama, and the drama was what attracted the kids there. There would have been no point in going there if it was just like any other Friday afternoon and on the beach. It, without the drama, the phenomenon didn't exist.
Rockers, it started, they screw you. And if you
what
take...
What
look you up and down and think, it's a funny way of dressing yourself, think you're a poof or something like that.
They think you're a poof?
Well, that's the way they look at you, as if to say, So you look at them back and they come over and start trouble. If you don't bother, they keep on at you, so you have to bother.
By the way, they're dressed, the makeup and that they have on them, and the eyeshadow, and eye all boots and that. Sometimes I fancy them myself.